नमस्कार, म अम्बिका हाङबाङ अङ्ग्रेजी सिकाइ रेडियो कार्यक्रममा यहाँहरूलाई स्वागत छ। चैत्र 11 गते यता देश लकडाउनमा छ, सायद हाम्रो दैनिकी फेरि के होला, होइन त? लकडाउनलाई समस्याको रूपमा मात्र नल्याउँ, विभिन्न माध्यमबाट शिक्षा हासिल गर्ने अवसरको रूपमा पनि प्रयोग गरौँ, हुन्छ नि? ल त विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनी हो, अब रेडियो सेटको नजिक आउनुहोस् है। यो अङ्ग्रेजी सिकाइ रेडियो कार्यक्रम हरेक दिन यसै समयमा रेडियो ताप्लेजुङ 94 मेगाहर्ज र रेडियो अठराई 101.2 मेगाहर्जमा सुन्न सक्नुहुनेछ। नोटबुक, कलम, पाठ्यपुस्तक र रेकर्ड गर्न मिल्ने सामग्री तयारी अवस्थामा पक्कै राख्नुभयो कि होला, होइन? यदि छैन भने तयार गर्दै गर्नुहोस् ल। आजको बसाइमा अनिवार्य अङ्ग्रेजी विषय अन्तर्गत कक्षा 12 मिनिङ इन्टु वर्डको युनिट 14 अन्तर्गत प्रेडिक्सन अर्थात् भविष्यवाणीको बारेमा चर्चा गर्नेछौँ। आजका मुख्य प्रस्तुतिका झलकहरू।
Prediction is an act of saying,
Yes, our school probably will be the best school of district this year.
ल त विद्यार्थी भाइ बहिनीहरू, ढिला नगरी आजको बसेको उठान गरिहालौँ। प्रस्तुति सहित आउँदै हुनुहुन्छ चेतन भट्टराई। अब कक्षाको ठाउँमै प्रवेश गरौँ, हुन्छ नि?
हेलो स्टुडेन्ट्स, नमस्ते। हाउ आर यु डुइङ? आई एम स्योर यु आर फाइन। It's me, Mr. Chetan Bhattarai. As usual, today I am here to facilitate you the Unit 14, Meaning into Words, a book of compulsory English from grade 12. The topic is prediction. You had also studied this topic in class 11 in Unit 19. So, it must not be a difficult topic, right? 5 marks grammar questions are frequently asked in the board exam, where each question carries 1 marks from this unit. Vidyarthi bhai bahini haru, aaja ma kakshya 12 ko meaning into words pustak antargat parne unit 14 ko prediction 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 topic को सहजीकरण गर्न तपाईहरु समक्ष उपस्थित भइसकेको छु। परीक्षाको दृष्टिकोणले यस लेसनको ग्रामर पोर्सनबाट धेरै जसो एउटा प्रश्नको 1 मार्क्स को दरले 5 मार्क्स को लागि 5 वटा प्रश्नहरु सोध्ने गरेको पाइएको छ। भाइबहिनीहरु रेडियो सुन्दै हुनुहुन्छ, हैन त? Dear students, let's turn on page number 135. Practice, PRACTIC, practice. But before it, let's discuss briefly about the topic. Okay, what's the topic?
Sir, the topic is prediction.
Do you know what prediction means?
We don't know, sir.
Okay, let's discuss about the topic. The word prediction, PREDICTION, prediction. Prediction is derived from 2 Latin words, pre and decare. Pre means before and decare means to say. That means prediction is an act of saying what will happen or must happen in future.
सर यसको मतलब प्रिडिक्सन शब्द ल्याटिन भाषाको प्री र डिकेयरबाट बनेको रहेछ जसमा प्रीको अर्थ बिफोर अर्थात् अगाडि र डिकेयरको अर्थ टु से अर्थात् केही कुरा भन्नु भन्ने हुँदो रहेछ त्यसो भए यसको अर्थ वर्तमानमा भविष्यको बारेमा केही कुरा भन्नु भन्ने हुन्छ होइन त सर
यस सर्टेनली यसको अर्थ वर्तमानमा भविष्यको बारेमा अनुमान लगाउनु हो
वी क्लियरली अन्डरस्टुड सर
थ्याङ्क यू स्टुडेन्ट्स लेट्स लिसन द कन्भर्सेसन भेरी केयरफुल्ली बिफोर डिस्कसिङ अन हाउ टु एक्सप्रेस प्रिडिक्सन हाउ द वर्ड्स लाइक डेफिनेटली आई एम स्योर प्रोबेबली आई एक्सपेक्ट आई डाउट इफ sure to, certain to, bound to, likely to, unlikely to, etc. are used in the conversation to predict the future.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, Radha. Do you know CE exam result is going to be published soon?
Yes, Krishna. National Examination Board will definitely publish the SEE result tomorrow.
I am sure all the students of our school will pass the SEE.
Yes, our school probably will be the best school of district this year.
But I doubt if our school will be the best school because this batch students are not as good as the previous batch.
Anyway, you are the best student of our class. You are sure to score A+.
But I am unlikely to score A+ because I couldn't do as good as I expected because I was ill. So I am bound to score A.
But I think you are likely to score A+.
Did you listen the conversation, my dear students?
Yes, sir, we listened. It is about the prediction of CE result, which has not been published yet.
Yes. Let me make you more clear through examples. Please, write down on your copy. Okay, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Number 1, there will, T-H-E-R-E apostrophe L-L, that means there will certainly be lots of people at the meeting. There will certainly be lots of people at the meeting, full stop. Now, number 2, there will definitely be D-E-F-I-N-I-T-E-L-Y, definitely be lots of people at the meeting. Now, number 3, I am sure there will be lots of people at the meeting. Now, number 4, there will probably be P-R-O-B-A-B-L-Y, probably be lots of people at the meeting. Number 5, I expect there will be lots of people at the meeting. Okay, similarly, number 6, perhaps, P-E-R-H-A-P-S, perhaps, there will be lots of people at the meeting. Okay, number 7. There probably won't be won't be lots of people at the meeting.
Number 8. I doubt if there will be lots of people at the meeting. Number 9. There certainly won't be, WON'T, there certainly won't be lots of people at the meeting. Did you complete it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Definitely, certainly, I'm sure, with future tense. Predict 100% probability, where the speaker is 100% sure. Similarly, probably, P-R-O-B-A-B-L-Y, probably, I expect, with future tense, predict 75% probability, where the speaker is 75% sure. Similarly, perhaps, P-E-R-H-A-P-S, perhaps with future tense, predicts 50% probability, where the speaker is 50% sure. P-R-O-B-A-B-L-Y, probably won't, W-O-N-T, probably won't, I doubt if, predict 25% probability, where the speaker is 25% sure. Similarly, certainly won't, C-E-R-T-I-N-L-Y, certainly won't, W-O-N-T, certainly won't predicts 0%, 0% probability, where the speaker is 0% sure.
Sir, yasko matlab definitely, I'm sure, sanga future tense prayog bhayema speaker afule boleko kurama 100% sure chan bhanera bujhnu parne rahecha. त्यसै गरी probably, I expect सँग फ्युचर टेन्स प्रयोग भएमा स्पिकर आफूले बोलेको कुरामा 75% स्योर छन् भनेर बुझ्नुपर्ने रहेछ. अनि पर्याप्तसँग फ्युचर टेन्स प्रयोग भएमा स्पिकर आफूले बोलेको कुरामा 50% स्योर छन् भनेर बुझ्नुपर्ने रहेछ. Ainata sir.
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, I got it. Probably won't. I doubt if prayog bhayema speaker afule boleko kurama 25% sure chan bhanera bujhnu parne rahecha. Ra certainly won't prayog bhayema speaker afule boleko kurama 0% sure chan bhanne bujhnu parne rahecha. Ainata sir.
Yes, you are right. Look at the above mentioned prediction. All the given statements predict the same matter with the different degree of probability. Okay, look at the first three predictions which you have copied down.
Sir, they are: there will certainly be lots of people at the meeting. Number 2, there will definitely be lots of people at the meeting. And number 3, I'm sure there will be lots of people at the meeting.
Okay, in these statements, the speaker is 100% sure that there will be lots of people at the meeting. Okay, what are in number 4 and 5?
Sir, number 4, there will probably be lots of people at the meeting. And number 5, I expect there will be lots of people at the meeting.
Yes, in these statements,
The speaker is 75% sure that there will be lots of people at the meeting. Okay, what is in number 6?
Sir, number 6, perhaps there will be lots of people at the meeting.
You are right. In this statement, the speaker is 50% sure that there will be lots of people at the meeting, because there is the use of perhaps in this sentence. Now, tell me number 7 and 8.
Number 7, there probably won't be lots of people at the meeting. And number 8, I doubt if there will be lots of people at the meeting.
Okay, in number 7 and 8, the speaker is 25% sure that there will be lots of people at the meeting. Now, number 9.
Sir, in number 9, there certainly won't be lots of people at the meeting.
Yes, in this statement, the speaker is 0% sure that there will be lots of people at the meeting. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, dear students, look at page number 135. Practice. All these statements carry different degrees of probability. Please read loudly the given instruction.
Okay, sir. Change the sentences below using sure to, certain to, bound to, likely to, and unlikely to.
Okay. Can you change the sentences?
We don't have any idea, sir.
Okay. We should use the structure. Okay. Write on your note copy. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, write down. Subject plus M is R plus sure to, yes, you are sure to, certain to, bound to, B-O-U-N-D, bound to, likely to, unlikely to, plus Bhavan plus dot dot dot. Okay, in this structure, the words like sure to, certain to, bound to, likely to, unlikely to, among them, any one word should be used. If the statement has, I am sure, use sure to. If the statement has will definitely, will certainly, use bound to or certain to. Similarly, if the statement contains probably won't, I doubt if, use unlikely to. Similarly, if the statement contains will probably, I expect, use likely to. But never forget to cancel the words like definitely, I'm sure, I doubt, I expect, probably, etc. And at last, in the part of dot 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 of the structure, copy down the part of statement mentioned after verb. Did you understand?
Sir, yes ko matlab, diye ko statement like subject plus M is R plus sure to, certain to, bound to, likely to, unlikely to, प्लस भवान प्लस डट 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 को प्रयोग गरेर पुनर्लेखन गर्नुपर्छ। तर पुनर्लेखन गर्दा स्टेटमेन्टमा दिइएको स्योर टु, सर्टेन टु, बाउन्ड टु, लाइकली टु, अनलाइकली टु लाई कसरी प्रयोग गर्ने भन्ने सन्दर्भमा, नम्बर एक, स्टेटमेन्टमा दिइएको डेफिनेटली, आई एम स्योर, आई डाउट, आई एक्सपेक्ट, प्रोबेब्ली जस्ता शब्दहरूलाई हटाउनु पर्छ। त्यसै गरी नम्बर दुई, आई एम स्योर भएको वाक्यमा स्योर टुको प्रयोग गर्नुपर्छ। विल डेफिनेटली, विल सर्टेनली भएको वाक्यमा बाउन्ड टु अथवा सर्टेन टु मध्ये कुनै एउटाको प्रयोग गर्नुपर्छ। नम्बर तिन, प्रोबेब्ली वन्ट, वन्ट, आई डाउट इफ भएको स्टेटमेन्टमा अनलाइकली टुको प्रयोग गर्नुपर्छ। नम्बर चार, विल, विल प्रोबेब्ली, आई एक्सपेक्ट जस्ता शब्दहरू भएको वाक्यमा लाइकली टुको प्रयोग गर्नुपर्छ। र अन्त्यमा स्टेटमेन्टको भव पछाडिका शब्दहरू जस्ताको तस्तै लेख्नुपर्छ, होइन त सर?
Yes, you are absolutely right. Okay, let's try the exercise. Number one, it's in page number 135, practice. Okay, number one, the price of bread will, W-I-L-L, will, definitely, D-E-F-I-N-I-T-E-L-Y, definitely go up within, W-I-T-H-I-N, within a few weeks. What is its answer? Do you know?
Sir, its answer is, the price of bread is bound to go up within a few weeks.
You are absolutely right.
Okay, the price of bread will definitely go up within a few weeks. Yes, statement ma bhayeko will definitely. The price of bread will definitely cha ni. Tesko will definitely lai hataunu parcha. Tespachi statement ko subject ke ho bhana ta?
The price of bread ho sir.
Ho, yo subject ho. The price of bread subject ho. Tesaile yeslai jastako tastai lekhnu parcha hamro structure anusar. त्यसपछि द प्राइस अफ ब्रेडसँग इज एमआर मध्ये के को प्रयोग हुन्छ भन त?
इजको प्रयोग हुन्छ सर।
हो, अब के भयो त? द प्राइस अफ ब्रेड इज, अब स्ट्रक्चर अनुसार स्टेटमेन्टमा विल डेफिनेटली छ भने त्यसलाई हटाएर बाउन्ड टु को प्रयोग गर्नुपर्छ। अब के भयो त?
The price of bread is bound to भयो सर।
हो, the price of bread is bound to, हामीले त्यो bound to लाई चाहिँ will definitely word लाई हटाएर प्रयोग गर्यौँ, bound to को प्रयोग गर्यौँ। अब त्यसपछि verb 1 को प्रयोग गर्नुपर्छ। हेर त स्ट्रक्चरमा subject plus am is are plus हाम्रो यस स्टेटमेन्टसँग मिल्ने शब्द bound to, bound to plus भगवान्को प्रयोग हुन्छ। अबको पालो आयो भगवान लेख्ने। अब स्टेटमेन्टको मा भएको भवको भगवान फर्म के हो हेर त?
गो हो सर।
यस, जिओ गो। अब गो लेखेर त्यसपछि स्टेटमेन्टको पार्ट के छ हेर त? अप विदिन अ फ्यु विक्स लाई जस्ताको तस्तै लेख्नुपर्छ। अब के भयो त? द प्राइस अफ ब्रेड इज बाउन्ड टु गो अप विदिन अ फ्यु विक्स। ओके, नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेन्ट, देयर विल प्रोबेब्ली बी मोर फाइटिङ इन द क्यापिटल। क्यान यु टेल मी द आन्सर?
सर, इट्स आन्सर इज, there is likely to be more fighting in the capital.
Yes, you are absolutely right. Now, number three, he probably won't arrive.
He is unlikely to arrive.
Number four, I expect there will be lots of people at the meeting.
There is likely to be lots of people at the meeting.
Number five, I doubt if the miners will go on strike.
The miners are unlikely to go on strike.
Okay, number six, there probably won't be much snow this winter.
There is unlikely to be much snow this winter.
Yes, you are right.
Sir, it is easier than we expected.
Okay, my dear students, at last, let me give you some exercise for practice as homework. Okay, write down please. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, number one. Dear, T-H-E-R-E, dear will definitely, D-E-F-I-N-I-T-E-L-R, definitely be a new tickets, T-I-C-K-E-T-S, tickets left, L-E-F-T, left. Full stop. Number two. I doubt if they will, they will move this summer. S-U-M-M-E-R, summer. Okay, similarly, number three. Are you writing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, number three. I am sure a new chairman will be appointed soon. Will be appointed, A-P-P-O-I-N-T-E-D, appointed soon. Full stop. Okay, number four. The government probably won't make the wearing. The government probably won't make the wearing of seat belts compulsory. Number five, in 10 years time, everyone will have a digital watch. Okay, number six, it's the last question for today. By the end of the century, comma, cars will probably be obsolete. O-B-S-O-L-E-T, obsolete. Okay, thank you, students. See you soon in the next program. Stay home, stay safe. Namaste.
Chetan Bhattrai Sarlai, dheri dheri dhanyabad. Karyakram kasto lagyo ta? Aajako basai पक्कै पनि सिकेमूलक बन्यो होला। कार्यक्रम सुन्दै प्रश्न तथा जिज्ञासा टिपोट गर्नुभयो कि होला, हैन त? प्रश्न तथा जिज्ञासा अंग्रेजी सिके रेडियो कार्यक्रमको फेसबुक पेज @radioeducationspf को इनबक्समा र radioprogramspf@gmail.com पठाउन सक्नुहुनेछ। प्रश्न तथा जिज्ञासाको समाधान सहित थप सिकेको लागि भोलिको कार्यक्रममा पुनः भेट हुनेछ। पठन पाठनको क्रममा कुनै जिज्ञासा भए निम्न ठेगानामा सम्पर्क गर्न सक्नुहुनेछ। ठेगाना र सम्पर्क टिप्न तयार हुनुहोस् है। ह्युमेन प्र्याक्टिस फाउन्डेसन, फुङलिङ नगरपालिका 4, ताप्लेजुङ। फोन नम्बर 024-461-047। हवस् त, आगामी अङ्कमा पुनः भेट हुनेछ। म अम्बिका आङबाङ बिदा हुन्छु। नमस्ते। साबुन पानीले मिची मिची हात धोऊ, भेड़भाड़ में नजाऊ, रेडियो सुनऊ र पढ़ऊ। धन्यवाद।